confirmed a report that Kiss drummer Eric Carr has died of cancer. Carr spent much of the past 18 months battling various ailments, including brain aneurysms and heart surgery, and of course, a tumor. He was an 11-year veteran of Kiss.
Kiss special batteur, Eric Carr.
Bonjour tout le monde, bienvenue à Fax, Denis Talbot avec vous. À New York, Eric Carr, le batteur du groupe Kiss, est décédé des suites de complications dues à un cancer. Il avait 41 ans, il s'est joint au groupe Kiss en 1981, suite au départ de Peter Criss. Carr est décédé à l'hôpital, il était admis depuis déjà un certain temps. Décédé hier, donc. D'autre part, on a pas...
Welcome to the Pepsi Power 30. I'm Teresa Roncon. It's been a rough weekend for the music industry. As you probably all know by now, Freddie Mercury, lead singer of Queen, has died. But so has Eric Carr, drummer for Kiss. Eric, unfortunately, was suffering from lung cancer, and he was sick in hospital in New York for quite a while. Last month, when we did our Kiss special, many of you showed concern for his health. Unfortunately, he has passed away at the age of 41. Eric was a drummer with Kiss for 11 years. He replaced Peter Criss in 1981. In 1980, he recorded 8 albums in all. So what we thought we'd do is put together a little montage of Eric's time with Kiss for you, and also play the last video he recorded, God Gave Rock and Roll to You, on the Pepsi Power 30.
It comes down to enjoying what you're doing, believing in what you're doing, and the audience believing in you and liking what you're doing. And you don't continue if you don't have the combination of those two elements. You know, you can't do it without the audience wanting what you do, and you can't do what an audience wants if you don't believe in it yourself. Boy, I hope that came out right.